ground down to its bones. Mosul is so quiet, spectral, where once it bustled. You ask yourself, where are its people? Where have ISIS taken them? And the answer is here. Trapped in the warren of the old city, the densely populated final holdout of ISIS here. It is a stalemate of shoot and wait now, weeks old. Where a few alleyways down, ISIS's mass hostage standoff begins. Tens of thousands of civilians held as human shields. You can see from these drone pictures, filmed during a massive ISIS counterattack, exactly how tight the streets are packed. In every one, hell could await. The Al-Nuri Mosque, from where ISIS leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi gave his only real public speech, its central prize. Each street, window, a bloody slog. The now abhorrent truth clear that ISIS leaves nothing intact behind it.
There, in the distance, is the reason why ISIS are fighting so hard in these dense, winding streets to hold the Iraqi police and military back. That is the Al-Nuri Mosque, very much the ideological heart in Iraq of their self-declared caliphate.
They want more American precision firepower. Up until now, their help is weak, he says. They have advanced, precise weapons, and with intelligence, they can help us better. So far, astonishingly, Stabrak, aged 4, has both stayed in her home and survived. And does not flinch once. There is no life under ISIS, her father says. No food, no water, no electricity. We had to dig a well to pull water. The first thing she's really known is the police. She loves them like kids in her school. And there, as the shells still rain down, are those who will never leave. And those who do as fast as they can. Far enough out, they are ferried to camps. Brimming with stories of ISIS using human shields, of herding civilians into kill zones to make them die with them.
They would besiege us and use us as a human shields. Take people and families as they withdraw.
My brother and the rest of his family are besieged. ISIS hit them with sticks, dragging him away. He's crippled. He can't go anywhere.
These voices, a fraction of the cacophony of suffering inside, in a fight that may take months more yet.